Hello, I am Dr. Santhakumari, Chief Physician and Managing Director of Matha Ayurveda Hospitals, Trivandrum. Today I want to speak about the Ayurvedic approach in the treatment of macular degeneration. It is a serious eye disease of the present era. I think the incidence is gradually increasing. And again, the number of people searching for alternative medicines, treatment procedures for the management of macular degeneration also is increasing. That itself means the existing procedures are not enough to control the problem, or people are not satisfied with the results. So that is why they are searching for other systems. Then what is macular degeneration? From the name itself, we will get a general idea. It is a degenerative condition. Degenerative condition of macula. Macula is the most sensitive part of the retina. Retina is the innermost part of the eyeball, lying inside the eyeball posteriorly. And macular degeneration is a degenerative change of this area. We know the physiology of vision from very childhood itself. The light rays reflected from the object passing through the air in a parallel way, and finally it is getting converged on retina. And when the light rays focus on retina, a series of changes takes place. Different types of changes. First, then chemical changes, then electrical, then nervous. And finally, a nerve impulse is formed. This nerve impulse is conducted to the brain stem and is converted to actual visual sense. So from this physiology, we can understand one thing. This macula, where light rays focus, is the base point for the function of vision. So itself, whenever there is a pathology in this area, the vision will be directly affected. There will be direct defects for different types of visual senses. So when we think of the vision, we can see that there are different aspects. It is not only, we can cannot say simply vision. There are different aspects for vision. One is distance. That means a patient should be able to see an object in a particular distance in a correct way. Then comes size and shape. Any object should be seen in its correct size and shape. Then position. In the visual field, we should be able to see the an object in its correct position. Like that, there are different aspects. So when vision is affected means there is a chance of defects in any of these things. Sometimes the object cannot be seen in its own distance, or sometimes its size and shape may be defective, or some in the visual field, the position. That means in certain positions object cannot be seen. Like that, different types of defects may develop. Now, as far as macular degeneration is concerned, the main symptoms the patient experiences are mainly one is this distorted vision. That means size and shape of the object may be different. For example, vertical lines or horizontal lines may be seen wavy or zigzag. And sometimes the shape may be blurred, cannot be seen sharp. Then some areas in the visual field may be blank or dark. It is not visible. These are the main symptoms they see. And they will be very difficult to face the bright light or bright sunlight especially. These are the main symptoms they experience. Gradually the changes increase, and the symptoms also become more and more, and there is a chance of practical problems. They will not be able to read, or not able to drive in the night, or not able to get this correct shape or color of the object. So it is really a practical problem. When considering the treatment session, we have to consider macular degeneration in two different classifications. One is dry ARMD. Among the different types of macular degeneration, ARMD, that means age-related macular degeneration, is more important and more common. So now I am talking about ARMD only. The other topic can be discussed later. Dry ARMD means the patient will be having some particular very characteristic changes, and the onset will be gradual. And the second group is wet ARMD. In this group, almost this onset will be sudden, and the complications also will be more, and chance of getting worse or getting to blindness also is more. Now considering the wet dry ARMD, when diagnosis is very easy. There are so many methods now, just like fundus photography and OCT, etc. It is very easy. According to Ayurveda, the patient will be vata dominant. I don't know whether you are aware of the terms vata, pitta, kapha, etc. These are the basic principles of Ayurveda. So here we have to strengthen the eye by normalizing the function of vata. There will be deposits of dry drusens, that is an end product of the metabolic actions, and it will be dry in nature. So the patient will be seeing central dark areas and dry feeling, and also blank areas in the visual field. These are the symptoms. So for the management of this condition, Ayurveda is considering this medicated ghee as the first level of treatment. For this, there are different procedures. Not only taking ghee inside, but oilation, different types of medicated oils for head. And then there's a nasal drops. These are extraocular procedures. For this, Shirodhara, Shirovasti, Shirabhinga, these procedures are selected. That means, but selecting one medicine, we can use it in different ways, different procedures. These procedures are selected according to the nature of the patient, clinical stage of the disease, body constitution of the patient, and also considering the other systemic disease, if any. For example, diabetes or hypertension, hypercholesterolemia, like that. Since it is age-related, the chance of having other systemic diseases are very, very, very high. So considering all these changes, all these factors, we can do these types of general treatment procedures. The other treatment is inside the eye. That means purely ophthalmic medication. For that, tarpana, putabhaga, etc. are the treatment of choice. Through this, we can boost up the functional capacity of the eye and protect the retina from being damaged. Then, bringing back the damaged cell to normal, the aim of the treatment will be to protect the existing cells being degenerated. So, by these methods, we can do that. In the second group, that is wet ARMD, the onset will be sometimes sudden. There will be hemorrhages inside the retina, because actually the macular area is avascular, that is no blood vessels. But in this case, the macula will be encroached by blood vessels, and there will be bleeding or leakage of the fluid from the vessels. This will make the macula more edematic or later degenerative. So to control this thing, we have to normalize the functioning factors kapha and pitta. So the management is little more tough than the first group, but it is possible in Ayurveda. For this procedures are same, that means shirodhara, etc. But medicines should be very selective, because oil is not at all necessary, it is not preferable in this group. But other types of medicines are there for the same procedure. Maybe takradhara, kashayadhara, etc., etc. So many procedures are there. In the same way, medicines inside the also is different from that of the other group. It will be very selective. Netra seka, netra aschodana, purambara, these are very effective. Not tarpana padavaga, etc., just like in dry eye RMD. So, in short, I can say that in Ayurveda, simply saying macular degeneration, treatment is not, cannot be performed. We have to see what type of macular degeneration is it, what is the clinical stage, and what is the position of the, is the condition of that particular person. All these factors should be considered before coming to Ayurveda, these treatments. So if you are doing like this, a differential diagnosis, then selective medicines and selective treatment procedures, that can protect the vision, and it can arrest the progress of the disease, and like that protect the vision. Thank you. The patient shared all these things with you. It's Dr. Santhakumari, Chief Physician of Matha Ayurvedic Hospitals, Trent.